Four of the largest manufacturers of baby food in the U.S., the companies behind Happy Baby, Gerber, Beech Nut, and Earth's Best Organics, are all responding to a staff report that was put together for a subcommittee in the U.S. House of Representatives. This report talked about having dangerous levels of arsenic, lead, cadmium, and mercury in the baby foods. Now, three other companies were cited in the report and were told did not respond to the subcommittee, including Walmart with the Parents' Choice brand and the companies behind Sprout and Plum Organics brands. Now, know this, the FDA has only set one metal standard for baby food, and that is 100 parts per billion of arsenic allowed in infant rice cereal. Now you might be asking yourself, why do they allow any at all? Well, toxic elements like arsenic occur naturally and they enter the food supply, like the rice that's growing right here. And how does it happen? It happens through the soil, through the water, through the air. They cannot be completely avoided, even using organic farming practices. But that doesn't mean that it's just a free-for-all. The FDA does indeed set guidelines and test foods. This report showed current FDA measures aren't enough, though, and concludes that the FDA should set maximum standards for each heavy metal, require companies test their finished products for these metals, and finally put warnings about higher levels on those labels. In the meantime, what do you do if you are feeding a child rice cereal and baby foods?
I would say one of the biggest concerns I saw in reading the report were the organizations that didn't want to participate. So as a parent, I would say I'm a little more cautious about doing those, and I have given them to my kids. So, you know, it did make you sit there and think. So we would assume that all baby foods have had it. So one brand, maybe varying the brand and then making sure that you're varying the amounts of it.
Now, there is arsenic in the rice that you may be eating for dinner. Again, it is naturally occurring, but we do have some recommendations for how you can cook the arsenic out of the rice. That's in our web story in the Two Wants to Know section.